All right, so now I'm really getting into serious here. And when I say serious, I mean artwork. I mean artwork exposure. I mean who is the artist of the ocean? Who is the artist of the ocean of the last, oh my gosh. I'll bring it into the 70s time frame. What is that, 30, 45 years? The artist of the ocean is Mr. Moon. Mr. Moon. Is the name Moon. M-O-O-N. This particular artist has created an ocean so tremendous, so realistic. So realistic as to be exact. So realistic as to be exact. As a formateur that cries through your mind in the day and the night in remembrance. I have been there. I have been to his ocean. Don't you understand? Artwork. It is only the artwork that cries the bevy through your mind, through your entire life. I do not deal with artwork that is a gesture of get out. You just pitied me for a day in my mind and gave me entertainment elaborate. I deal with artwork that is real, don't you understand? Real. As the waves tremest through. As the waves tremest through on continual. This man is the artist of the oceans, and his name is Moon. M-O-O-N, I believe is a spelling. When we have a man such as this, in this particular time frame, he's accoladed, but my God, is he even alive? I presume not. Presume he did not make it through this particular time. But his oceans did. Do you understand? His oceans did. His oceans are there. His oceans are ours right now. To resume in splendor, in enjoyment. And then know forever that they are there. Thank God for him. Thank God for him. And I'm not even a God believer. But thank God for him. Thank God for him. I know this seems like fake video, huh? Fake video. Sometimes it is when you drink the alcohol. It starts to become this fake person I am. Person I am. I find something else black to drench my tears in. Seems as, you know, only the black of monarchy, of the morir of the dead, of the drench of the population that you have to deal with. It seems like that's what black is. Did they die the right way? Did they die the wrong way? So, Mr. Moon there, And yes, he has a beautiful son. Oh my gosh, beautiful son. And I try not to acquaint myself with the fascination of his particular beauty as a son. Oh my gosh. Try not to. Try to stay away from that organization of female. Because it is quick, isn't it? It's quick for a female to enjoy and enjoy a beautiful man. But the musician artist is his father that I know, that I have ever seen and witnessed in the past, that I have seen as an action, the scene of the action and endurance as a follow-through, that is absolutely the one that cries, the heart of what an ocean is, the heart of what an ocean belongs to. It is a rupture of the self. It is not something beautiful always. It is a disheartening moment, and it is also a moment that takes you, that you must belong there also. It is a dangerous artist, Mr. Moon. You, with your son named Brian. Is a dangerous artist. The ocean, the most traumatic species that we know. It's not a tame place. It's not ever. I see another wave, I see another wave, I see another wave. Oh, it is another scene. I see another wave, I see another wave, I see another wave. We're talking the highlighter in the no. We're talking realism. We're talking he has been there. He has been there in such an immensity, such an immense proportion that he owns the oceans. As if he is a titan. You understand? As if he is some type of titan god. So anyway, this was a video specific for the moon artist of the oceans. He is congratulated incredulously by my particular royaume de Val de France. You can call it de France, you can say Francais, that just means French speaking. You say France, it just means French. France as the country. So yeah, you just say France, the country. But in reality, he is the god. He is the god of the oceans and speak. He is the god who makes you cry. He is the god that makes even the Borg, that come out from years of rusted indenture going, this isn't working, you're too viral. He is the Borg. Wake up. Hello. Do you cry and rust some more? He is this man. Without the realism, we die. We must embrace realism as artists. I understand the fanatra of abstract. The hey, I did it, I'm great. The spasmatica, I understand. But when we are talking the endeavorance of It is a serious proportion. It is a serious proportion so much as to make the cosmonaut of the walkers of populi computeri programma state brained. It makes them cry, and it makes them rust. We must make them rust, do you understand? It is not longevity for everyone. You're gonna live without emotion. You're gonna live without it. Are you going to deny that emotion lives in the realism? Right there, in the painter form, on the pentra. The pentra! The painter form. Are you going to deny it? If you deny such a fact, then you are there. You are walking as a Borg. You are walking as one that defers a tear and says, hey, nothing from my eyes ever. Not one drop. It does not prove longevity. Does not prove that you will live forever. That you do not cry. Does not prove anything of this. It merely proves you are disheartened. Merely proves that you are gouged out. Do you understand? Gouged out. That you have nothing left. You have nothing left in your heart. And you never had anything left in your heart to begin with. Merely chooses that you said this path. This path. This direction. This direction was yours. That you prefer to not see the oceans as real. That you prefer not to see realism as an artist state. That you prefer just an abstract splash. Oh, that's wonderful. Anyway, greatest artist ever I've ever seen. Greatest artist ever I've seen. Ever. On this gosh damn planet. There was one more with the wool from Park City who has made the wool. He's made the wool in a painting and is an amazing artist. I do not know the name. Made the wool in a painting. But there are several out there, but my gosh, there's just a small little handful at this point. My gosh, a little tiny handful. I don't even have enough. I don't have enough to give into my handful that will express how small this is, a handful of true artists. Do you understand? So don't go and throw at me to say that you are an artist ever! I do not accept a specie intermittent copy of China. Already ordered because somebody needed the expressant earrings. Yeah, I have your copper. I know how to rap. Big deal. Big deal. I can rap. I'm not impressed. Put it to the paint. Put the skeleton on the paint. Everything. Don't you understand? Put it right back to the paint. Put it right back into the colors, put it back into the actual dimension of the paint throat. And actual paint, every bit, every momentum, every stroke. Enough of Van Gogh being the big whatever. This is about future now. And we live in future. Do we believe that the ocean even exists as it is? Picture, picture, take. Picture, picture, take. With my marine headlands taking another picture at a photo at the other side of Land's End. And my picture, picture, take. Another picture, picture, torture of a tourist. I have to be here. I took the trip. I took the photo trip. I had to take the trip, you know. I have to take the picture. Does that cry the ego? Does that melt the heart? Does that make the squander off? Does that make it just like, oh, I'm alive? So as the ocean continues, his days up, his days down, his days up, his days down. The cliffs, the beach. Mr. Moon, you win. You win. You are the god. You are the god of this last 100 years. But nay, perhaps you are the god of perhaps thousands of years, because you have had the audacity to absolutely endure. Where in the wake of, I will say, the bodegas of, I can do this and I can do this, and look, it looks like a flower. Oh my gosh, and I am absolutely flower power. It looks like a flower. Do you understand? I love you. I love you also. I love flower power also. Because I love flower power also, I accept it. But no. It's garbage. Understand? I'm sorry, woman who loved anything flower power. Garbage. We are talking, looking at reality. And what reality endures into the futuric state? Reality is a deliverer. You want to bring your little precept, of that this is the endurance state into the future. You want to bring that this little conundrum of what you thought was your perception of the future, your perception of now, as the be-all and end-all. It is almost as if fighting a crown, isn't it? Like you are your own monarchy wanting to be. So I must disrupt it. I must disrupt this woman, this man, who thinks that this is a beautiful. It is not a beautiful. I'm looking back at Mr. Moon. Mr. Moon. And yes, I believe it's San Francisco Bay Area specifically, but maybe before other places, possibly East Coast. That man, the most consummate artist of our time, 1960s on. What a phenomenon. What a phenomenon. Let's take that. And how beautiful, an easy name, Moon. The man Moon, who knows how to paint the oceans. The man named Moon who can paint the oceans. It's almost an incredible, isn't it? It's almost as incredible as, are you kidding me? There's a man named Moon who only knew to paint the oceans beautiful and not some disturbance state. No, we bring the oceans beautiful to the future again and again and again. No matter if there's a computer that has a virus, we don't care. We bring the most beautiful to the computer virus. And the computer virus will be like, well, I guess I'll be beautiful oceans again and again and again. I cannot help it. I cannot help it. Computer virus says, I cannot help it. Ping attack, ping attack. I guess I will eat it as that, such. I am the most beautiful oceans again and again. Somber. Sleepy. Brilliant. Awake. Alive. Clashing. Oh my gosh. Just emotion rich. Emotion rich. We never stop with this man as being the most beautiful artist of the oceans.